Hundreds of people from all parts of Oregon converged on the Bandon Marsh National Wildlife Refuge on October 1, 2011, braving blustery winds and fickle rains to celebrate the estuary's formal dedication and the ocean's return to the marsh. Hosted by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service and Ducks Unlimited, the event opened with an invocation and ceremonial dance by members of the Coquille Indian Tribe. Speakers including Congressman Peter DeFazio and U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service Deputy Director Rowan Gould addressed the crowd. DeFazio and Gould had high praise for Ducks Unlimited's leadership in masterminding the project, as did U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service Regional Director Robin Thorson.
But I want to single out Ducks Unlimited because we hear about them for their engineering, and we hear about them and their funding, and we hear about them as a great contributor to waterfowl because of their name, Ducks Unlimited. But they are really about wetlands and habitat, and they are about leadership. So their role is so essential in conservation across our landscape. We are privileged to have worked with them here.
The sea had been walled away from the Nielsen unit of the marsh by earthen dams and tide gates for more than 100 years. It took a decade of intricate, complex, and intensive work by DU biologists and engineers to complete what is now the largest estuary restoration project in Oregon history. Restoration to the Nielsen unit is uniquely significant in a number of ways. For thousands of years, the Coquille Indian tribe depended heavily on the site for fishing, so the project specifically included protection of priceless ancient archaeological sites. From a fishery standpoint, the Coquille River is one of the most important habitats for coho salmon. By restoring 430 acres of estuary habitat, Ducks Unlimited has returned 40% of the available coho salmon rearing habitat to the Coquille River watershed. As a result, instead of being imperiled, the Bandon Marsh National Wildlife Refuge is now a living testament to Ducks Unlimited's commitment to wetland conservation. But without support from Capitol Hill, funding for projects like Bandon Marsh may be smaller in amount and less frequent in the future. Tom Dwyer, Director of Conservation Programs for Ducks Unlimited, voiced appreciation for Congressman DeFazio's ongoing campaign to protect endangered wetlands.
Finally, our special thanks, of course, go to Congressman DeFazio for his role on the Natural Resources Committee and the Transportation and Infrastructure Committee. We continue to need his help to get these kinds of projects done.
The dedication concluded with Congressman DeFazio being honored for his work in securing a large portion of the funding for the project. He helped secure $765,000 in land acquisition funds from the Land and Water Conservation Fund and another $4.2 million for North Bank Lane improvements. A plaque bearing his name now adorns the Bandon Marsh Wildlife Viewing Platform. For more information on the Bandon Marsh restoration and other Ducks Unlimited projects, visit the DU website at www.ducks.org.